Before you begin your exploration, stop to read the information panel at the bottom of the stone staircase leading up to the fort. This brief introduction to the history of the site will greatly enhance your visit. Walkways lead you around the bastion itself, offering close-up views of the ancient moss-covered stone structure. Although it is not possible to walk among the ruins, you can get a good impression of its size and strategic importance. Look out for the three large veins of stone connected by crossways, which are thought to have been the base of a tower, now destroyed. The lookout post is a reminder of the vital part the fort played in warning the city of approaching enemies in the past. Nowadays, it provides a peaceful photo opportunity with impressive views across the Manila skyline.
Designed by the Jesuit priest and architect Antonio Sedeño and built from 1586 to 1587, the Fort Nuestra Señora de Guia was a circular tower meant to defend Manila's southern Bayside boundary. In 1593, the upper portion of the tower was demolished after suffering from cracks. The rest of the structure was integrated into a new bulwark called Baluarte de San Diego.
Baluarte de San Diego dates from the end of the 16th century when it was constructed as part of the fortifications of the walled city of Intramuros by Jesuit priest Antonio Sedeño. Originally named Nuestra Señora de Guia or Our Lady of Guidance, the bastion was primarily designed to repel invasion. Its sturdy structure is testament to its purpose and has helped it to survive wars, earthquakes, and the ravages of time.
The circular fort was excavated in 1979 and the baluarte was restored by 1992. A garden was added at its base and the first stone fort in Manila is now an archaeological park. The garden area, which was once the site of a foundry and soldiers' barracks, is today rented out for private functions. The 16th century stone provides a unique backdrop while the fountain and pergola complete the perfect setting for special events and occasion.
Today in Manila, the fort has become a popular tourist spot that depicts the most of Intramuros. A polished garden was built around the fort along with the sturdy fortification. The garden also features shaded walkways, fountains, old cannons, and the structures from the preceding century.
The bastion is surrounded by beautiful gardens, crisscrossed with pathways, and adorned with lush plants, fountains, and an attractive pergola. Not surprisingly, this is a popular place for weddings, family parties, and other special occasions, so it's worth checking before you visit to make sure the gardens are not closed for a private function. As you stroll around, pay heed to the notice warning of the flying golf balls, as stray balls from the nearby golf course have been known to catch people unawares. Baluarte de San Diego is south of Intramuros, opposite Rizal Park. Take the light rail to Central Station, from where it is only a short walk. The fort and gardens are open daily for a modest admission charge.